Well, grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you. I am so honored to be part of this event with you today. My name is Sarah Arthur, and I am one of the co-leaders of this Prayerdemic today. This is my husband, Tom. He's the pastor,
peace, friends.
Pastor of Sycamore Creek Church in Lansing. Both of us have been involved in a group called CORE, Congregations Organizing for Racial Reconciliation. And also involved in various things related to Church of Greater Lansing and have built friendships there. But the main thing about today is with all the other stuff that we have to pray about in our nation, in our state, in our city, and we have all day, all Memorial Day to pray about those things, we want to take this 1 hour to pray specifically about acts of racialized hatred in our nation. And to say the names of those who have been lost in the Black community, especially recently on this Memorial Day, to stand with our brothers and sisters in Christ, to respond in obedience to God's word in speaking out in the face of these losses and in the face of the grief of our Black brothers and sisters. And so thank you for being part of this prayer time with us. We submit all of this to God. Anna Maria Horn has been coordinating this event today with us. And as she has said multiple times in this process, God, work your work. And that is what this event is. So the flow of what we're going to be doing is very similar to a worship service. We're going to be entering into the presence of the Lord through music that Anna Maria has coordinated. And then we're going to spend some time reading an open letter that over at this point, almost 100 white Christians in Lansing have signed as a response to this call from our brothers and sisters of color to speak out when our hearts are breaking in this nation. And then we're going to enter a time of prayer. And that time of prayer will have 10 different points that have been put together for us by Anna Maria Horn and Justin Reed, who are people of prayer in this community. Anna Maria Horn is a gospel recording artist and worship leader. Justin Reed is part of Spirit of Christ Church, but also heads up House of Prayer in East Lansing. And we're so grateful for their leadership today. Following the first part of the prayers, we'll also do another song and then some more prayer. And then we'll reiterate the 4 calls to action that the open letter expresses to send us into the rest of this week and month and year that God is calling us to, with 1 last song at the end. Thank you for being with us. We pray God's blessing on this time. And we invite you to join us now as we enter into worship.
Listen, I invite you to sing this song with me. You already know it. Are you ready? What are you turned into? Why? I told you. Open the eyes of the blind. And there's no one like you. Oh no, none like you. Into the darkness you shine. Hey! Out of the ashes we rise. There's no one like you. No, no, no. None like you. And this is all I have to say. That my God is greater. My God is stronger. God, you are high. say stronger. Stronger. My God.
My God.
If he's holy, then you say holy.
Holy.
If he's stronger, then you say stronger.
Oh my God.
Let it rise.
Amen.
Amen.
Oh, thank you, God.
Man, we got our windows open here in my room, and we got the music blasting, and Sarah and I are singing at the top of our lungs, and I'm imagining our neighbors next door, like, hearing all this noise coming and this music.
It's a prayerdemic.
It's a prayerdemic.
Let it be a contagious, unstoppable force, a movement of the Holy Spirit in this city. And in hello, Holt, out there, you too. Anna Maria, thank you for your leadership with that music. Thank you for bringing us into the presence of God. Mm-hmm. We are, we know that even as we enter God's presence and his presence inhabits the praises of his people, and that we bring the sacrifice of praise, there are days for people of color when it is really hard to bring that sacrifice of praise. Mm-hmm. And for white Christian brothers and sisters to recognize those moments when we have failed to be the kinds of people that God is calling us to be with you all, that we have failed to walk alongside you in singing these songs and praying these prayers and grieving with our brothers and sisters. And so we want to now make the turn towards reading this open letter that has been published online. When we initially sent out the press release, we said 70 plus white Christians had signed this. As a response of obedience to the cry of the heart of God in our brothers and sisters of color. And as of today, there are approaching 100 signatures, and we praise God for that, even as Ahmaud Arbery's mother wakes up to another day without her son. Too often, we have failed to do this. And so we're going to read this letter, and I'm going to call upon a couple of folks that are in the Zoom room with us today to help with this. I'll get us started, and then I'll have my husband Tom jump in. And it's long, but so is the grief, and so is the brokenness over centuries of injustice in our nation. And so we're going to just settle in to this and not rush it and not be thinking about all the other things that are on our plates to do and all the other prayers that we could be praying today. This is a gift and a moment of grace and a moment of being in submission to the call of God. An open letter from white Christians in Lansing to our fellow believers. May of 2020, dear brothers and sisters, as believers in the Lord Jesus Christ in the greater Lansing area, we have a biblical responsibility to join with our brothers and sisters of color who are speaking out against the sin of racialized hatred in the murder of Ahmaud Arbery in Georgia. The voices of Ahmaud, Breonna Taylor, and too many others have been silenced forever, and the Holy Spirit convicts us that we have chosen to be silent too often and too long. Tom, could you take the next part?
This time, we respond to the prompting of the Spirit and the Scriptures to learn to do right, seek justice, defend the oppressed, as the prophet Isaiah says in chapter 1, verse 17, and to speak out for those who cannot speak, from the wisdom of Proverbs 31, 8 through 9, and to weep with those who weep, from the Apostle Paul in Romans 12, 15. In the name of Jesus Christ, together with our brothers and sisters of color, we utterly reject and renounce such sinful acts of racism and the purposeful delay of justice. Furthermore, we join the call to a biblical, prayerful, peaceful, and unified Christian response in the following ways.
Pastor Jesse Still, would you take the next paragraph, please?
First, we respond in humble obedience to the clear direction of God's word. Biblical lament rings out from communities of color, including here in the Capitol. How long, O Lord, as Psalm 35 laments. Trayvon Martin, Alton Sterling, Sandra Bland, Freddie Gray, Tamir Rice, Mike Brown, Botham Jean. We join our Black brothers and sisters in remembering their names and the needless loss of their lives. These were beloved people made in the image of God, as Genesis 1:27 states, and for whom Christ died, as seen in 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 15. It has already been said, but needs to be said again. Racially motivated systems, ideology, and actions, as well as the purposeful delays of justice, seek to diminish the image of God in Black lives and strip the Black community of dignity, humanity, and peace.
Deanne Eddy, would you take the next paragraph, please? Might need to unmute yourself.
Our biblical mandate is clear. Micah 6:8 says, "He has shown you, O mortal, what is good, and what does the Lord require of you, but to act justly, to love mercy, and to walk humbly with your God." It is in that spirit that Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. addressed white clergy in 1963, inviting them to join him in the biblical call to unity against racialized hatred and injustice through his famous letter from Birmingham jail. We come together in that same spirit of obedience to God's word.
Second, we express to our brothers and sisters of color that we stand with you, we grieve with you, we will not abandon you in this moment. The blood of this young man cries out to heaven, and we cry out also. We will remain vigilant with you in calling out such acts as sin, in holding this nation to account, in not perpetuating racialized violence or rhetoric, either by our participation or by our silence. We grieve and confess that our sinful history has done terrible damage to you. What mercy we have been given is undeserved, and we don't take your trust, grace, or friendships for granted. Thank you for letting us stand with you. Pastor Justin, would you take the third one?
Third, we join the call to partnership in action for churches and Christians of all races and ethnicities to stand together in Lansing as a unified people of God against such acts of hatred so that the name of Jesus can be lifted up in our city. During COVID-19, we have seen even more clearly the societal fault lines that continue to destabilize and damage people of color. The impact on communities of color is devastating on many levels. The instinct to hunker down and protect our own is strong, and thus all of us risk eroding relationships across racial lines that could otherwise bear powerful witness to the reconciling gospel of Jesus Christ in Lansing.
Tom, Pastor Tom, would you take the next section, please?
The Apostle Paul says in Ephesians 4:3-6, "Make every effort to keep the unity of the Spirit through the bond of peace." Likewise, Paul says in Galatians 3:38, "There is neither Jew nor Gentile, neither slave nor free, nor is there male and female, for you are all one in Christ Jesus." The Greek word for "you" in these verses is plural. When one suffers, all suffer. When one cries out, we all cry out. As one in Christ, we must move swiftly, speak clearly, and act decisively in the healing name of Jesus to come together against the principalities and powers at work in our land.
Deanne, would you take the next line and the first call to action?
For these reasons, we join with our brothers and sisters of color in a call to action that has four simple components. Number one, we help spread the word about and join a virtual pandemic planned for noon today, Memorial Day, in the greater Lansing area. Congregations of all races and ethnicities are encouraged to pray from home via live stream. We pray to lament and to speak out against the murder of Ahmaud and others. We pray for the Spirit of God to continue the healing and reconciliation that racialized hatred, especially amidst this pandemic, threatens to undo. We pray to lift up the name of Jesus in Lansing, for he has said that if I be lifted up, I will draw all men unto me. Join the Lansing Prayerdemic Facebook group. Watch via Zoom. Questions can be directed to Anna Maria Horn and Sarah Arthur at the emails listed.
Thank you. Pastor Jesse, could you take number two?
Two, commit to worshiping with, whether virtually or in person, once restrictions are eased, a church that is not of our racial or ethnic identity at least once this year. With many churches streaming online services, there's never been a more accessible opportunity to join with other congregations in lifting up the name of Jesus. More info, links to various online services, and tips on how to do this well will be posted at this address.
Tom, will you take number three?
Commit to educating ourselves on the deep racial divides in our nation, particularly as these relate to churches and the long, hard work of scriptural reconciliation. It took 500 years to reach this point. It will not be fixed overnight and never without the Holy Spirit. There are several local resources for this kind of work, including a webinar featuring local pastors and conversations. More details will be posted soon. You can contact me if you're interested in that. CORE, or Congregations Organizing for Racial Reconciliation, a regional nonprofit which creates a network of anti-racist churches through training and accountability. You can find us on Facebook under CORE Lansing. And Lansing contacts Pastor Linda Gardner, Church of the Elohim, and Deacon Diane Garden, Pilgrim Rest Baptist Church. More resources will be posted on the Lansing Prayerdemic Facebook group link above.
Justin, would you read the number four, the final call to action?
The final call to action is an open invitation for churches to have their singers, songwriters, and worship leaders record and submit original songs for a collection/album that can be used in worship around the region in the coming months and years. The Apostle Paul says in Colossians 3:16, "Let the message of Christ dwell among you richly as you teach and admonish one another with all wisdom through psalms, hymns, and songs from the Spirit, singing to God with gratitude in your hearts." Songs in the 3 to 5 minute range can express praise, lament, reconciliation, unity, and love. Please submit them for consideration to Lansing-based gospel recording artist and worship leader Anna Maria Horn, directly at the listed email.
We may be socially distant, but we are spiritually united in Jesus. May our unified prayer be a contagious, unstoppable force, a prayerdemic greater than any hatred, any principality or power that may seek to fragment or destroy God's people or defame his glory. In the name of Jesus and the power of the Holy Spirit, and all God's people said,
amen.
Amen. And you can see, we're just going to scroll quickly or take our time through this list. But we have some folks that have supported this letter, people of color who have been both offering their wisdom and input and leadership, and also who signed it as a way to support this movement of God in Lansing. These are ways that God has already been moving and people who have already been speaking out. But it is time to join in that with God. Thank you, Lord, for your work. Thank you, God, for your work. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We praise you, God.
I'm just really struck by the breadth of churches represented. Mm-hmm. Of course, the churches listed are not an endorsement by the church, but just the people from those churches is pretty astounding.
Yep. Yeah. And many, many, many folks of color who are present today and also who are behind the scenes giving input and wisdom for all this. Philippians 1:4-6 says, "In all my prayers for all of you, I always pray with joy because of your partnership in the gospel from the first day until now, being confident of this, that he who began a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus." Amen. So we're going to enter into this time of prayer with that letter on our hearts and the cry of our brothers and sisters of color on our hearts. And I'm going to invite each one who's on the prayer team to make sure they have their prayer points in front of them. And we're going to make our way through this, and I'll cue each of you for those as well. There were two people who couldn't be with us today. One is Joel Nagel, who is the lead minister of Lansing Church of Christ, and he will he pre-recorded a prayer. And the other is Katie Burmeister, who's associate pastor of Crossroads Church, and she also pre-recorded a prayer. As we enter into the presence of God, we bring these voices, these prayers to you, O Lord. And I invite Justin to get us started.
Our first prayer focus is praying to repent on behalf of the sins of racism committed in our nation and pray the blood of Jesus to cover over them. I'll be praying from 2 Chronicles 7:14. It says, "If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves, pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven, I will forgive their sin, and I will heal their land." And so, God, I come to you on behalf of my city, on behalf of my nation. God, we want to repent on behalf of all of the wrong done in our nation and in our history. Every form of racial injustice and discrimination that has happened, Lord, we say we are not okay with those. And we, just like Daniel repenting on behalf of the people of Israel, we repent to you, God, for these things. We say they were wrong. We acknowledge them. We don't cover them up, God, but we confess them to you. And you say that if we confess our sins, that you are faithful and just to forgive us our sins and purify us of all unrighteousness. And so, God, we ask that you would forgive us of the wrongs that we have done in our nation, Lord, the ways we have not loved like you command us to, the ways that we have treated people unjustly, God, that innocent blood has been shed. Lord, we repent of these things. We bring them to you. We repent of them. And we ask, God, that you would cover over them with the blood of Jesus. Lord, I'm asking that the ways that these injustices, that this innocent blood still cries out to you from the ground, Lord, I'm asking that you would cover over these sins with the blood of Jesus, Lord, that no more destruction, no more loss of life would be perpetuated in our nation any longer, Lord, that generational patterns of brokenness, Lord, and things that we've been born into, God, we ask that they would stop in this time, they would not continue for another generation, that no more life would have to be lost, Lord. And we ask that you would come and bring your kingdom in this place. We know that you are so willing to come and make the wrong things right. And so, God, we say, come and bring justice where there has been injustice and start with our hearts, Lord. We ask that you would remove the plank from our eye before you go to anyone else, God. Start with us. Remove any wrong thinking, any wrong motives, God, in our hearts. We say, remove them from us first, and then purify our nation, Father. So we repent of these sins, these injustices, God. We repent of them and ask that they would be covered over with the blood of Jesus, and they would no longer harm anyone or wreak havoc in our nation any longer.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. We invite this video from Joel, and then we'll have Jesse.
Hi, I'm Joel Nagel. I'm the lead minister for the Lansing Area Church of Christ, and I want to pray a prayer of reconciliation from 2 Corinthians 5, verses 17 and 18. It says, "Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has passed away. Behold, the new has come. All this is from God, who through Christ reconciled us to himself and gave us the ministry of reconciliation." Let's pray through this passage. We pray to you, God, God of reconciliation, who has also given us a ministry of reconciliation. When a relationship is broken, Lord, it needs reconciliation. It needs to be fixed. And there are times when things are so broken that someone from the outside has to come and help relieve the enmity. There are times when we need a reconciler. Jesus, you've done this for us in our relationship with God. Each person was hopelessly separated from God because of our sin, but Jesus, you came. You sacrificed yourself and you restored our broken relationship with God. You've reconciled us to the Father, and we praise you. Thank you for your sacrifice that reconciles us to God when we had no hope. Lord, we had no hope, but we do have a responsibility. Our responsibility in reconciliation with God is to look at our hearts, our actions, and our attitudes, and accept that we are sinful, that we have caused this break and this disunity. And then in your grace, Lord, you not only reconcile us, you make us into ministers, into servants who are able to help others be reconciled through Jesus. You give us a ministry of fixing broken things, Lord. What an amazing trust you have in us. When we look at the sin of racism in our world, we see such brokenness, such disunity. We pray to you, God of reconciliation, that you would fix this. And in Christ, we know that it is possible, but Lord, we have to do our part. Lord, we have to see that we have sinned. We have to accept that we breathe the air of racism every day. It may hide deep in our thoughts, but it is in our hearts, in this society, and it affects people of color in profound ways. How can we be reconciled if we do not see the problem, the brokenness, the sin? Lord, I want to pray for my white brothers and sisters in Christ to have hearts with eyes, like Paul urged the Ephesians, that we could see with our hearts that people of color wake up in a world with different rules just because of the color of their skin, that we could be honest, not for the purpose of guilt or shame, but because if we don't see our brokenness, then how can we go to Jesus to have this fixed? How can we repent? How can we be reconciled? I want to pray specifically, Lord, for the Lansing area. There has to be change in our world, and that change has to start somewhere. Why not here, Lord? I ask that a wave of repentance, healing, and reconciliation would come from our humble city, from our churches. Let this be a place where people no longer wake up to different life experiences based on the color of their skin. Let this be a place where ideology takes a back seat to empathy and understanding. Let each of our churches and their leaders and their members be bold and unafraid to call out what's broken. I'm afraid sometimes, Lord. Forgive me. Give me boldness. Let us call out what is broken and be a light that the old could pass away, that the new could come. Let us be ministers of reconciliation. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Jesse, Pastor Jesse.
Amen. Hallelujah. Wow.
Hallelujah.
I'm excited. I have the privilege of praying our third prayer point. And I'm excited about this one, praying that God would restore the years that have been destroyed because of racism. Mm-hmm. Come on. Out of Joel chapter 2, verse 25, where the prophet speaks for the Lord, saying, "And I will restore to you the years that the locust has eaten, the cankerworm and the caterpillar and the palmer worm, my great army which I sent among you." Yeah. Father in heaven, I thank you that on this day as we gather in your name, you hear our prayers. You hear the prayer of every person present on this call and virtually through the web stream. And where there is unity, you command a blessing. And Lord, I thank you that today our hearts are in one accord for your goodness and your justice to be made known where wrong has been seen and experienced by many. God, and I thank you today that you are by your very nature a restorer. You are by your very nature a redeemer. You are always the one that comes running after to make the wrong things right. It's you. You are the one who makes wrong things right. You are the God of justice. No one else can do justice that works except you. And we just acknowledge that first in the name of Jesus. True justice, righteousness, comes from you, and your word promises, and we know from your nature, that you will restore everything that's been stolen or taken. Lord, especially today, we're praying for those in our nation of minority communities who have lost much to the hands of racial hatred. And we say no more, and we invite you to do what you do. Lord, in your word, you promise that when someone gives something, it's going to come back to them, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. But you also promise when it's taken, God, that you don't just give back. You multiply blessing in its place. You will give back seven times, you say in your word, what was taken from the enemy of racism. So, Lord, I just declare that and stand for that in our community, in our state, and in our nation, God, that over the many, many years of injustice, God, we would see you from the hand of heaven restore and multiply back seven times more than everything that's been taken over many years, God, in the form of blessings, favor, opportunities, finances, livelihood, generations, people that have been lost, God, that you will multiply on every level. Everything that's been taken will be given back, restored, and then seven times more. And God, we thank you that you will remove the things, the racial hatred and the roots and the systems that have caused these things to be taken from our brothers and sisters, and that you will have the final say. And Lord, we just say and declare and believe that until all has been restored, the story is not over. You are not done, and we will not stop pressing until we see every wrong made right, and everything that was lost restored, and then some, because that is who you are, and you are the one who our faith is in. And we're asking, trusting, believing according to your will. When we pray according to your will, we have what we ask for. And I thank you for that in Jesus' name. Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. Oh, God, you are moving. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you for this team and mm-hmm. for the words being lifted in prayer. Deanne, would you bring us prayer point number 4?
Ooh, yes. We pray against the stronghold of racism and that every ideology and act be pulled down. We issue a spiritual cease and desist order today. We pray from 2 Corinthians 10:4, for the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. And Matthew 18:18, assuredly I say to you, whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven. So, Father, we thank you that you give us this word, that you give us the authority to pray and to release your power here on the earth. And we just want to bind racism in the name of Jesus. We serve you a cease and desist order this day that you can no longer operate in our city, in the state of Michigan, or in our nation. We say, come down in Jesus' name. You may not operate here anymore. Holy Spirit, we ask you to come and to do this mighty work in our nation. We say that the spirit of pride may not operate. Spirit of domination, we bind you in Jesus' name. You may not operate. We loose the Holy Spirit. We loose love. We loose unity upon our nation. We release a healing salve upon our nation to replace these hurts that have been there. God, would you come in like a flood and take away all the debris that needs to be removed from our society and bring your grace, bring your mercy, and bring your freedom. God, may every person of every color be able to walk in the identity that they have in you, God, that there would be nothing that would keep them back from being everything that you have created them to be. May it start in our city, God, here in Lansing, Michigan today, that every person can walk and be and do what you have created them to do. You created good works for them in advance, God. May they be able to walk in them without any limits in our city. In Jesus' name, amen.
Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. we've been hearing in prayer and in this letter from a lot of white Christians who are responding in obedience, Lord, and now we're making the turn to hear from our brothers and sisters of color who are leading the way already, who are giving out of today of grace in this time. And we invite Charlie Dobson to lead us in the next prayer point.
So I will be praying for God to give beauty and healing for every place that has been broken and hurt through racial injustice, according to Isaiah 61:3, that says, "And provide those who grieve in Zion to bestow on them a crown of beauty instead of ashes, the oil of joy instead of mourning, and a garment of praise instead of a spirit of despair. They will be called oaks of righteousness, a planting of the Lord for the display of his splendor." So, Father God, I just come to you right now, just thanking you for being a God who is not intimidated by our mess. I thank you, Lord, for being one that is not intimidated by our brokenness, Lord God. For Heavenly Father, you are one that is willing to meet us where we are, that you are one that is willing to meet us where we are hurt, and not only willing to be present, but you're willing to heal us, Lord God. So Father God, I come to you in this time just praying on behalf of those who have been hurt, Lord God, by racial injustice. I pray, Lord God, that you would give them the faith in this time to remove the sackcloth and ashes, Lord God, that they have found comfort in. I pray, Lord God, that you would give those who have been hurt the faith to no longer wake up each and every day finding contentment and being broken and being bitter and unforgiveness, Lord God. We pray right now that you would give them to faith, Lord God, to walk in healing, Lord God, that you would give them to faith to be delivered, that you would give them the faith to come to you knowing, Lord God, that you can meet them and you can give them new life, that you can give them a greater hope, Lord God, than what they have experienced, Lord God. So we pray right now, the Heavenly Father, that they would have the faith to put on the garment of the crown of beauty, Lord God. The Heavenly Father, knowing that when you give them beauty for ashes, Lord God, that there is a great exchange, Lord God. The Heavenly Father, that they can trust you in the process of becoming beautiful, of becoming victorious, Lord God, knowing that the testimony that you have given them would empower those to do the same, Lord God. We pray, Heavenly Father, even right now, that the oil of joy, Lord God, will saturate their hearts, that it will saturate their minds, it will saturate every experience of the past that have left them in mourning, Lord God. We pray, Lord God, that no longer would they hold on to mourning, Lord God, that mourning will no longer be their portion, but we speak now that joy will be their portion, Lord God, that love and forgiveness will be their portion, Lord God, that empowerment will be their portion, that victory will be their portion in this time, Lord God. We pray, Heavenly Father, that just as I said before, that just even with the garment, as you present to them the garment of praise, Lord God, that they will be willing to let go of the sackcloth and ashes, Lord God. The Heavenly Father, by faith, they will be willing to pick up the garment of praise, knowing, Lord God, that you are able to restore, that you are able to heal, that you, Heavenly Father, that you are able to give them a joy that they have never experienced, Lord God, before in this time. And we just pray and we just thank you now, Lord God, for how you are going to allow them to be like oaks of righteousness, Lord God. So we pray now, Lord God, just even as oak trees, Lord God, that, Lord, we just pray that they would be like trees planted by the water, Lord God, that their healing, that their faith, that their joy, that their restoration, Lord God, would not wither regardless of what season that they are in. Lord God, that it will be as though a standing a testimony that will extend beyond the generations to come, knowing, Lord God, that if you were able to do it for their ancestors, Lord God, that you could do it for them as well. So we thank you now for the testimonies that are going to come. We thank you now, Lord God, for just even their faith and just the testimonies of healing that are going to take place in this time, Lord God. And we just give you all the glory, honor, and praise, Lord, in your son Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. We're going to spend some time in song just to allow the prayers to be to deepen within us, and then we'll make the turn to our last set of prayers.
Sometimes it's hard for me to understand why we pull away from each other so easily, even though we're all walking the same road, yet we build dividing walls between our brothers and ourselves.
But I don't care what label you may wear. If you believe in Jesus, you belong with me.
And the bond we share is all I care to see. And we can change this world forever if you would join with me. Join and sing that you're my
continue in our time of prayer. Pastor Linda Gardner, would you take us into the next prayer point?
Sure. The next prayer point is that God would give grace to forgive to those who have been wronged. I'm going to come from several scriptures and then we'll pray. Mm-hmm. At least I should be exalted above measure by the abundance of the revelations. Mm-hmm. A thorn in the flesh was given to me, a messenger of Satan to buffet me, lest I be exalted above measure. Mm-hmm. Concerning this thing, I pleaded with the Lord 3 times that it might depart from me. And he said to me, my grace is sufficient for you. Mm. For my strength is made perfect in weakness. Mm. Therefore, most gladly, I would rather boast in my infirmities that the power of Christ may rest upon me. From 2 Corinthians 12:7-9. And the word became flesh and dwelt among us. And we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. And of his fullness we have all received, and grace for grace. For the law was given through Moses, but grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. John 1:14-17. Colossians 3:13. Bear with each other and forgive one another. If any of you has a grievance against someone, forgive as the Lord forgave you. Then Peter came to him and said, Lord, how often shall my brother sin against me and I forgive him? Up to 7 times?
Yes.
I do not say to you up to 7 times, but up to 70 times 7. Matthew 18:21-22. Father God, we come to you today to magnify your name, O Lord. You alone are worthy of all of our praise, glory, and honor. You are great, O Lord, and greatly to be praised. Forgive us, dear Lord, for wasting your time in the foolishness of the sin of racism. Our hearts ache. Our hearts are broken over the racially profiled murders, assaults, batteries that continue to happen in this country and in this world. Tragically, Ahmaud Arbery is one of the latest ones. We pray for comfort for his family and for your justice, dear God, your justice to prevail. Rodney King, who was brutally beaten on March 3rd, 1991, never advocated for hatred or violence against his attackers, saying that we all need to get along. Lord, we have proven over and over and over again that in our own strength, we cannot get along. But Lord, I'm asking that your church, the Ecclesia, would be compelled to get along by demonstrating the love of Jesus one toward the other. Then this country that was founded on Christian principles will show the light of Jesus Christ to this world. As your word tells us, to forgive is not just a choice, but it is absolutely mandatory to be Christ-like. We declare and decree that the church's mandate, our Christian duty, with the help of the Holy Spirit, is to love one another, to give grace, to give mercy, to forgive, and to do as Jesus did. In Jesus' own example to his disciples of prayer, he said, Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Then Jesus taught, "For if you forgive men their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you do not forgive men their trespasses, neither will your Father forgive your trespasses." Father, Father God, help us to forgive as you have forgiven us. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. I'm going to invite Pastor Luis Torres to do the next prayer point.
All right, friends. Today I get to pray that our city, the city of Lansing, would be one, just as Jesus and the Father are one. And our prayer, my prayer point is based off of John chapter 17, verse 20 to 23, and it says like this: "My prayer is not for them alone. I pray also for those who will believe in me through their message, that all of them may be one." That all of them may be one. "Father, just as you are in me, I am in you. May they also be in us, so that the world may believe that you have sent me. I have given them the glory that you gave me, that they may be one as we are one, I in them and you in me, so that they may be brought to complete unity. Then the world will know that you sent me and have loved them even as you have loved me." Pray with me. Dear Heavenly Father, we come before you thanking you, Jesus, for your grace and for your mercy, Lord God. But also, Lord God, we thank you for your justice. We thank you, Lord God, that your justice brings healing. We thank you, Lord God, that your justice brings unity. We thank you, Jesus, that your justice, Lord God, goes against the grain of what we think is best for us. And Lord, we just ask, Lord, that you continue to bring unity in this nation, Lord God. In this nation, Lord, that in its clause says that all men are created equal. God, our own constitution holds us to a higher standard. And Lord God, we just ask that you continue to bring unity in us, that you continue to heal the wounds, Lord God, of the oppressed. Continue to heal the wounds of the marginalized. Continue to be there, Lord God. And Lord, may the people in power be able to have humility, Lord God, that you have asked of them, Jesus. That humility may be able to reign, God, in our hearts. God, in this nation that's consumeristic, in this nation, Lord God, that believes that we can do all things by ourselves, we know, God, that we are weak, but that you are glorified in our weaknesses. That you, God, ask us to humble ourselves in order, Lord God, for you to heal our land. And Lord God, we just ask for that humility to come down, Jesus. May that humility, may we be able to hold hands with your humility, Jesus. As you, God, were all powerful. Jesus, you were all powerful. You were one with the Father, the creator of the universe, yet you decided to die a sinner's death. You decided, Lord God, to come down on earth and die a place that you didn't deserve in order to save a person like me who did deserve that cross. And Lord, we just ask, Lord, that we be able, that your crucifixion, that your death, Jesus, be a mirror to all of us, that we are all in a level playing field, that we are all the same at the cross, that there is no hierarchy at your cross. And God, I ask, Lord God, for my white brothers and sisters, Jesus, that they link arms with us so that way, Lord God, we can seek your humility together as we are faced with the mirror of your crucifixion. And Lord, we just ask that you continue to bring us together, that you, Lord God, your word says that we can do all things in you who strengthens us. Lord God, knowing the Philippians and knowing, Lord God, the persecution that they were going through, Lord God, the Apostle Paul still tells them and we can do all things through you who strengthens us. And we believe that, and we declare that today, Jesus, that we can do all things, that we can do this one thing, Jesus, that we can do this one thing in your name and only in your name. And Jesus, bring us together. In your name we pray. Amen.
Yes, Jesus. Yes, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray it. We're going to bring a video from Katie Burmeister from Crossroads Church for the next prayer point.
God, I thank and I praise you for who we are in you, Lord. I thank and I praise you that in you, by your blood, that we have been made new, that we are a new creation, and we put off our old selves. We die to our old selves and we live for you, Lord. By the power of your Holy Spirit, may we live out who we have been called to be as your sons and daughters, as your new creation, Lord. I thank you for the newness of life that we have in you, Lord. I thank you that in you, that nothing else matters, that it does not matter what nationality we are, what ethnicity, what is our educational background, our socioeconomic background. I thank you that the way that the world identifies us is not how you identify us, Lord. I thank you that our identity is solidly rooted in you, Lord, as your sons and daughters, and that we are brothers and sisters in you, Lord. I thank and I praise you for that, and I pray that by your Holy Spirit, you would give us the power to live into that newness of life, that you would give us the power to live into our calling of who we are in you, Lord, and that by the power of your Holy Spirit, that we would view one another through your eyes, Lord, that we would view one another as our brothers and sisters, as your sons and daughters made in your image, Lord. I thank and I praise you for who we are in you and the newness of life that we have in you, Lord. Thank you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Pastor Luis, another prayer point, and then we'll have Pastor Tom wrap it up.
Now we're going to pray for God to make our city look like his kingdom. Wonderful. That our city may look like his kingdom, with every tribe, every tongue gathered together around Jesus. Revelation chapter 7, verses 9 through 10 tells us this. After this I looked, and there before me was a great multitude. Say it with me, great. A great multitude that no one could count. From every nation, tribe, people, and language, standing before the throne and before the Lamb. They were wearing white robes and were holding palm branches in their hands. And they cried out in a loud voice, "Salvation belongs to our God who sits on the throne and to the Lamb." Oh, salvation belongs to our God who sits on the throne and to the Lamb. Pray with me. Lord God, we know that your kingdom is a diverse kingdom. We know that your kingdom is made of every tribe, of every tongue, of every language, of every people group, standing before the throne and before the Lamb who was slain. And Lord, we just ask at this moment, Jesus, that we continue to seek your kingdom here on earth. Lord God, that we know that your kingdom is not some faraway future, some distant future, God. We know that your kingdom is not somewhere out there in the future and that everything will be better then. No. We believe, God, that your kingdom is here and now. That's what you preached when you were here, Jesus. You preached that your kingdom had come and you were the glimpse of heaven on earth. And Lord God, you've empowered us to be the glimpse of heaven here on earth. And God, we come before you as a nation repenting, Lord God, that one of the only institutions after the civil rights that did not desegregate was the church. God, we repent before you, knowing, Lord God, that we have not sought out your kingdom, that we have sought out comfort, and that we have sought out, Lord God, that we have sold out your kingdom, Lord God, for our own biases. And we come before you in repentance before you, Lord God. And we just ask at this moment that we continue, that our city and that our churches in our city may continue to look like your kingdom. God, we know that we can rest in your grace. And we know, Lord God, that you have mercy upon us. But God, your works are important, Jesus, that we continue to follow your works because we are marked as Christians. We are Christians because we are your followers and we are followers of your teachings. And your teaching was that the kingdom had come. And we just ask today, Jesus, that we continue to seek out that kingdom. That God, it makes us uncomfortable when we go to our church and we see a monoethnic church. That it makes us uncomfortable, Lord God, that we continue to seek out our brothers and sisters that are lost. Our brothers and sisters that still need of you, Jesus. No matter what our skin color looks, no matter what our ethnic background looks, God, we just ask that you continue to make us to look like your kingdom, your tribe, and every tongue. Señor, te pedimos que seas tú en medio de nosotros y que, Señor, tú te puedas glorificar en nuestras vidas, Señor. No importando nuestro lenguaje, no importando nuestra raza, no importando nada de lo que haya, Señor. Lo que es importante es que tú te glorifiques y que tu reino venga. En el nombre de Jesús. Amén.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
I've been asked to pray the last prayer point about blessings, honor, and favor that would come to the African-American community. In the spirit of Numbers 6:24-26, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. My mind went to Psalm 109 as I was thinking about this prayer, which is perhaps a strange place to start for a prayer of blessing, because Psalm 109 is maybe one of the hardest psalms in the Bible. It's the deep, raw anguish of someone who's cursing his enemies. But what if the cursing was turned upside down into a blessing? What if the cursing upon our black and brown brothers and sisters was turned upside down into a blessing?
Thank you, Lord.
Here's what that blessing might sound like. It's Psalm 109 upside down. My God, whom I praise, do not remain silent, for people who are wicked and deceitful have opened their mouths against our black and brown brothers and sisters. They have spoken against them with lying tongues. With words of hatred, they surround them. They attack them without cause. In return for friendship, they are accused, but they are a people of prayer. They repay good for evil and friendship for hatred. Appoint someone righteous to oppose their enemies. Let an encourager stand at their right hand. When they are tried, let them be found innocent. And may their prayers set them free. May their days be many. May they be given places of leadership. May their children have fathers and their wives husbands. May their children be rooted in families. May they be built beautiful homes. May a creditor forgive their debts. May no one plunder the fruits of their labor. May everyone extend kindness to them and take pity on any fatherless children. May their descendants be grafted in, their names written into the next generation. May the iniquity of their father be forgotten before the Lord. May the sin of their mother be blotted out. May their sins never remain before the Lord, that he may remember their names from the earth. For they always think of doing a kindness and gave generously to the poor and the needy and the brokenhearted. They love to pronounce a blessing. May it come back on them. They found no pleasure in cursing. May it be far from them. They wore blessing as their garment. It entered into their body like water, into their bones like oil. May it be like a cloak wrapped about them, like a belt tied forever around them. May this be the Lord's payment to our brothers and sisters of color from those who have had evil spoken of them. And you, sovereign Lord, help them for your name's sake. Out of the goodness of your love, deliver them. For they are poor in spirit and need of your mercy, and their heart is wounded within them. They fade away like an evening shadow. They are shaken off like a locust. Their knees give way from fasting. Their body is thin and gaunt. They are an object of scorn to their accusers. When they are seen, heads shake. Help them, Lord my God. Save them according to your unfailing love. Let them know that it is your hand, that you, Lord, have done it. While others curse them, may you bless them. Yes. May those who attack them be put to shame.
Yes.
But may your servants rejoice. May their accusers be clothed with disgrace and wrapped in shame as in a cloak.
Yes.
With their mouth, they will greatly extol the Lord. In the great throng of worshipers, they will praise you. For you stand at the right hand of those in need of your mercy to save their lives from those who would condemn them. In the name of Jesus, and by the power of your Spirit, and all who agreed said, amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Well, we're going to just reiterate those closing, the four calls to action from the letter before we head out into the rest of this day with song. Again, we are remembering that Ahmaud Arbery's family, Breonna Taylor's family, are spending this first Memorial Day without them. And we know that the grief of their families doesn't end when we end. And the grief of the Black community continues even as we have claimed in the name of Jesus and through the power of the Spirit, God's healing and reconciliation in this city. And we walk into that beautiful truth in Jesus' name. So the four points of the letter, these calls to action. This month, we are doing the Prayerdemic. In June, we will be posting ways to worship and tips on and different links of ways to live stream worship with churches that are not of your racial and ethnic identity. We're many of us going to probably still be sheltering in place, and so it's a chance to visit those congregations and begin to experience the kingdom of God in different ways. In July, we will have more information about ways to continue to deepen training in around issues of race in our nation and the deep trauma to communities of color, and how that's especially problematic in churches and perpetuated by churches. And so we'll have more information about that, including CORE, Congregations Organizing for Racial Reconciliation, and other opportunities. And then in August is when Anna Maria Horn will be looking for the music, original songs that are crafted by different congregations that can be pulled together in a collection for use in worship throughout the coming year in congregations, so that we are singing with one voice songs that are unique to this city and unique to all of these different congregations. So that deadline will be August for the music. And then in September, we'll begin to cycle back through those calls to action again and hopefully join in prayer.
It strikes me that right now, that first point, share the Prayerdemic, you can just simply share this video out to your timeline or to your church's page. Mm-hmm. And that's something you can do right now.
Mm-hmm.
We hadn't talked about this, but it also strikes me the music videos that we created, if we could mm-hmm. make those mm-hmm. available for people. I was thinking, man, I'd like for our church to worship with Anna Maria and the team that she's pulled together. That would be wonderful for just a Sunday morning.
Yep. So be sure to stay tuned through the Lansing Prayerdemic page. Invite people to join that page and make sure you watch for notifications from there. We're going to head out now with one last song. We praise God for each and every one of you, for the leadership of our Black brothers and sisters in calling us to this time of repentance and obedience to the Word of God. And we pray God's blessings on the rest of your day and your week, your families, and may the name of Jesus continue to be lifted up here in our city.
You need Everybody look at somebody and tell them, I need you.
I need you.
You need me.
You need me.
We're all apart.
We're all a part of God's body.
Stand with me.
Stand with me.
Look at somebody, tell them, agree with me. Open your mouth and say, I need you.
I need you.
Let me hear you. You need me.
You need me.
For we're all.
We're all a part of God's body.
Stand with me.
Stand with me.
Agree with me.
Agree with me.
From my mouth.
With words from my mouth.
I love you.
I love you.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God.
I need you to survive.
We need you. Thank you, Jesus. I want to thank all of our brothers and sisters of color who have been walking on this journey long before any of us entered the room, sometimes long before any of us were born, and who have continued to pray and will continue to pray. Please stay in touch through the Lansing Prayerdemic page, and we'll continue to post information about ways to stay connected. Thank you, God, for CORE and for Coggle and for all the congregations and communities who have had people present today. May God bless you and keep you. May his face shine upon you. May he be gracious to you and give you peace. We love you.
Amen.
Amen.
Peace out.
Peace.